morning. Today we are going to detect the presence of hydroxyl group in the given organic compound. So the given test helps in identifying the hydroxyl group. The first is sodium metal test, second ester test, and the third is ceric ammonium nitrate test. So now we are going to perform these experiments one by one. Now we will proceed for experiment number 1, that is sodium metal test. So first of all, we are required to have very small amount of organic compound in the test tube. Now in sodium metal test, take a dry very small piece of sodium metal and add it to the organic compound very carefully. Now you can see the brisk effervescence of hydrogen gas. This shows the presence of alcohol in the given organic compound. Now we are proceeding for the second experiment, that is ester test. For this experiment, we require organic compound, concentrated sulfuric acid and acetic acid. During this experiment, take 2 ml of organic compound in a test tube. Now add 2 ml acetic acid to it. After this, add 1 to 2 drop of concentrated sulfuric acid. Heat the contents in a water bath. Keep the same apparatus for 5 minutes. After warming it for 5 minutes, cool the content. Now, after cooling, pour the content of the test tube in a beaker having cold water. On smelling, present fruity smell is obtained. This confirms the formation of ester and also the presence of hydroxyl group in the given organic compound. So the experiment 2, that is ester test, confirms the presence of hydroxyl group. Now we proceed for the third chemical test, that is ceric ammonium nitrate test. In this test, we require small amount of organic compound and ceric ammonium nitrate solution. In this experiment, we add few drops of ceric ammonium nitrate solution to the organic compound. Formation of red coloration detects the presence of hydroxyl group in the given organic compound. After doing all these 3 tests, we confirm that the given organic compound contains hydroxyl group in it.